Hey, any shit is the 9th of February 2020. I hope you're all doing well. I'm going to share with you about the first 10-12 minutes of this video that was shared with me. It's important that you watch this, and I'll leave a link in the description that'll pick up the rest of the video where it leaves off, okay? This woman is explaining to us exactly the plans, all the wording, and the legal maneuvers that they put into effect once this world health emergency has been declared. And the United States has acquiesced by declaring that emergency. This basically hands sovereignty over to the World Health Organization, the CDC, so on and so forth. This is effectively medical martial law, which is far worse than regular martial law. This is a serious thing. Whether this virus is fake or real, perceived or actual, these mechanisms are being put in place. And this woman simply explains how that plays out. It's very important that you watch this. I mean, I was given some pretty serious downloads pertaining to this whole thing. There's a lot of things I want to share with you, and God willing, I will later on. But for right now, we're literally seeing the manifestation of the white horse as well as the red horse. This is my firm belief. The white horse is the UN, and it is the World Health Organization. The white horse rider carried a bow, and it's not a bow and arrow bow. It's called a toxon, and it is the simplest of fabric. This is meaning coming from a plant like a tree or hemp or something, right? But the base of it is the word teco, which is to produce from seed. Now, you got to understand this. The World Health Organization is the serpent on the scepter, on the staff, on the UN map with the 33 sections. And around this map is a wreath, a crown, which is exactly what the crown the white horse rider wears, a Stephanos, to twine or wreath, the wreath of the UN and World Health Organization. This is the seed of the serpent, and it's come forth to conquer and to conquer, to pursue, prevail, and to get victory. The corona, also known as a crown, is simply a mechanism, and it appears as though they are putting this mechanism in full effect, bringing forth the red horse. The red horse comes to take peace from the earth and for men to kill one another. And he's given a great sword, which defines as war, judicial punishment. And let's not forget, this virus comes from Red China, whose mascot, basically, is the Red Dragon. There's a ton of things I want to share with you guys. And I mean, God willing, I will get to this. But first and foremost, pay attention to what this woman says. And like I said, I'll leave a link that will pick up the video right where it leaves off here, okay? She's telling you the truth and trying to get you prepared for this. Spiritually, most of all, but also physically and mentally, you need to be prepared for these things. Because this may very well turn into a scenario that most people are completely and totally unprepared for.
Hi, this is Celeste, and this is the Celestial Report for February 2nd, 2020. And we're going to dive into the Federal Register today with information that you need to know and that you may face as early as this week. And that is why it is critical to get you this information. And that is why I'm doing this special broadcast. So anyway, this is the Federal Register that we're going to dig into. So right now, what we have going, before I dig into the Federal Register, is algorithmic warfare. All the elements of creation have been weaponized, and also the words. And this is on both the side of God and the side of evil. And just as a really quick refresher, if you followed my work, if you don't, just look it up. it's pivotal to know some a little bit of the backstory as we go into this. There were three Asilomar conferences. The first one was in 1975, and the decision was made by the policymakers to genetically modify all life on Earth. That's animal, human, plants, everything. The second component was the geoengineering component. It was in the form of a binary weapon style. And so obviously that has been accomplished or is in process right now. That component, the framework, even though they had started before, was, I think it was 2010. And then in 2018 was the last component, and that is artificial intelligence or AI management of all life on Earth. Another thing that you need to be aware of is that back in 2005, the United Nations through the FAO issued three 1,500 page each documents that are living documents, and every May they are increased, so they don't just stay the same, they actually grow in size, kind of like a beast. And one of them is called the Terrestrial Animal Health Code, and yes, in this code you are defined as an animal and need to be managed. Anything in this code that applies to animals is applicable to humans. There is also the aquatic code, and there's also, very interesting, the manual for diagnostic and vaccinations. And I've been watching this since 2005, and many people didn't even realize that it existed. And so that's where you're going to see in the days to come all these diagnostics and vaccinations emanate forth and are regulated by the United Nations. It's also important for you to realize that independent labs are extremely rare right now. Maybe there's a handful of them, but almost all the labs are a part of the system, the global system already. And let's say they say that you have some sort of a pathogen and you don't believe them, and you want to get a third party opinion or independent opinion on whether you have this pathogen or not, it's almost going to be impossible for you to get that, because they're all the labs are one. With, like I said, there's a few independent labs, like probably Mike Adams is one of the few independent labs, but for the most part, they're all going to be lockstep with the same message. Now, another thing just before we dig in is, if you paid attention to the White House announcement this week after the World Health Organization declared the 2019 novel coronavirus a public health emergency of international concern, the White House, in harmonization with the World Health Organization, did their announcement, and we must pay particular attention to what they said. They are operationalizing. This is an operation, and it is a multi-layered cross-agency public health response. And what you need to know is, within our Constitution, at the time our Constitution was formed, public health was a big issue. We didn't have the sanitation. There wasn't the access to running water or, you know, basic understanding of different health things that we have and take for granted today. And so the founders of the Constitution, conscious that they wanted a healthy people, they kind of left public health out on its own, apart from the Constitution. But right now, global entities see those holes in the Constitution. And if you say, or if you use the words for the health, safety, and well-being of the public, that basically suspends any constitutional protections that you have, and you really need to understand that. Another thing, just before we dig in, we got a couple more things and then we'll just dig right in. First off, the coronavirus, I've been hearing, oh, this is just a coronavirus. That's, you know, you get this little tiny cold and you're going to get better in no time at all. You need to understand that the novel in front of the coronavirus means that this is a laboratory engineered virus. You might want to think of it as a GMO of viruses, and it is weaponized. It has potential for great devastation. Whether it's real or perceived, this is the biological 9/11 attack that has been unleashed upon the world. So what has been established, because they knew that this was coming, is a pan enterprise architecture for biosurveillance with interoperability. And what that means is, I mean, it's got several parts to it. There's loose coupling, there's contracts, which we're going to discuss, there's autonomy, there's the AI portion. This is going to be run by artificial intelligence, abstraction, reusability. Everything has to be reusable these days. Composability, statelessness, so it goes beyond sovereign borders. And as I've stated for the last several weeks, that this is sovereignty's last hurrah. After this, we're going to see a real concerted effort by global governance to eradicate states and discoverability. And you might think, oh, this is new. This is just this novel coronavirus is something new. No, actually, it was cited in the August 15th, 2016 Federal Register for severe acute respiratory syndrome, which was also related to the Middle East respiratory syndrome, which is MERS, and also related to hemorrhagic fever, Lassa, and Ebola, and also the highly pathogenic avian influenzas, H5N1 and H7N9. So now what we are going to be looking at today is the Federal Register proposed regulations. They were submitted by the Health and Human Services on August 15th, 2016. They were addressing the control of communicable diseases, and it became finalized on October 15th, 2016. What you're going to see in the next few minutes is basically a medical martial law that was laying in wait for something like the coronavirus to come into being. So to really understand it, what I'm going to focus on today, although the document itself is 88 pages, are the definitions, because you might run into this tomorrow. I'm not saying that you will, and God forbid you won't, but it is possible, and that when the WHO did their announcement and when the United States did their announcement, it basically changed our paradigm. So I'm just going to go down the definitions in alphabetical order, so it is not how they are presented in the actual document. So you're going to see that there are agreements, and an agreement is entered into between the CDC and an individual expressing a voluntary agreement. This is like forced voluntary between the parties, that the individual will observe public health measures authorized under this part as the CDC considers reasonably necessary to protect the public health, including quarantine, isolation, conditional release, medical examination, hospitalization, vaccinations, and treatment. And so you are going to be forced into a contractual agreement with the CDC. So you need to be aware of that. You can all, apprehension means the temporary taking into custody of an individual or a group for purposes of determining whether federal quarantine, isolation, or conditional release is warranted. This means that any of us at any time, especially within the next month, can be apprehended by public health officials or law enforcement and forced into what we're going to see here in a few minutes. The communicable stage means the stage during which an infectious agent may be transmitted either directly or indirectly from an infected individual to another individual. That means that they may not be symptomatic. I mean, it starts at the very first day, and a person with a novel coronavirus may not be symptomatic for 10 days. The conditional release means surveillance as defined in 42 of the CFR 71.1 and includes public health supervision through in-person visits by health officials or their designees, telephone, or through electronic or internet-based monitoring. There's actually a little bit more about that that we will go into in a few moments. So you might be released and self-quarantine into your home, but it's going to be a conditional release, and you're going to have all these checkups and electronics to make sure. You're basically going to be placed in electronic prison.
So stand on the rock of Christ, trust in him, lean not on your own understanding, and peace and grace to you. Many fish.
Finally, my brethren, be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. Put on the whole armor of God, that ye may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places. Wherefore take unto you the whole armor of God,